What up, everybody? James here from Honest Cigar Reviews, and today I have a cool video for you. A little something different here. I got this off of eBay. I actually recorded the whole thing, but the sound wasn't working. So now it is, hopefully. But I got a nice box here. And yeah, let's check it out. A Colibri dual flame tool, cigarette, and pipe lighter. Very unique piece here. I got this for $10. And I wasn't sure if it was going to work or anything. You know, a lot of times if you go on eBay and you're looking for vintage lighters, if you don't see it actually working, it's probably not going to work for you. A lot of times the seal inside's broken or something like that. But anyway, I got this and I tried to fill it with butane with my regular Zycar butane here. And this tip actually does not fit on this lighter. And so I called up, or I emailed Colibri, and I said, what's the deal? I have this lighter. It looks like it's in mint condition. And they pretty much told me, they said, we don't have that much information on it, but we know it was made at least 37 years ago. So what we can do is we can you know, give you the web address for this guy who repairs Colibri lighters, vintage Colibri lighters. And his name is Sean from sparksoftime.com or sparksoftimevintagelighters.com. And basically he repairs all kinds of stuff, and he fixes O-rings, and he, you know, a lot of times in old lighters, the fuse is, or the flint is fused in there, so you have to like drill it out. And so he basically does everything, and he specializes in Colibri lighters. So I'll put a link in the description there if you have a vintage Colibri and you want it to be repaired or whatever. But basically, I contacted Sean and I said, hey, what's the deal? I can't refill this thing. He said, oh, you got to use Colibri monogas. Basically, Colibri sold butane back then with a special adapter so that you would buy Colibri butane. But he said, I recommend using Newport. So I got this today in the mail. And he said Newport is great for Colibri because it has near zero impurities. And also they have this top here. And with this top, there's you know, all these different attachments here, accessories. So it fits virtually every single lighter you can think of. And Sean said to use the blue adapter here. This is the Colibri Mono Gas. It's quite a bit thicker. Fits right on top here. And that's what you'll use for your lighter. I don't know why I needed to make sound effects, but so I filled it up. I was listening to see if the seal was broken. Seal is not broken. It took a while to clean out. I was using a pipe cleaner and using a zip tie and just kind of fidgeting around with it. And finally, I got it to work. There it is. So not bad. This is the, of course, for the cigarettes. And you pull it sideways, and that's for your pipe. So that's how you do it. I would say it's a little kind of hard to hold. It's like an old boy, but it's slimmer than the old boy. So you kind of have to, my big hands, I have to kind of like position it just right and then flip it. Now this is kind of cool because the spring actually goes all the way back. I don't know why you want that, but it's kind of a cool feature. And the flint, I got lucky because it wasn't fused in there. But another great thing about Newport butane is that it actually comes with two different flints. These little dots right here, that one and that one over there. Those are actually flints for you, so they would work just as fine in here, I think, as well. But a pretty cool lighter. You just pull down that lever, and you know, you can use it for pipes. It doesn't have a tamper or anything on the bottom, so that's the only downside I could think of this. Other than having to get a monogas adapter. But, you know, I got three of these Newports in the mail. And for three of them, they were $24. They're really, I mean, it's really a great deal. And on the back here of the Newport, you can see it has all these writings here. And this is for virtually any lighter you have. It's color-coded, so it tells you what you need. So, for instance, if you have a I Am Corona, you would want to use either a green or like a purple or a white, depending on one of those. But, you know, it narrows it down to every single one. So the first one for Colibri is the blue one, so that's pretty common, the monogas. But yeah, really just a versatile butane. And if you try to buy like just this and you're gonna put it on like on another one, it's a little loose fitting. I don't know if that would work or not. It's kind of flimsy. It seems better fitted on here. So I don't know if you just want to buy. I don't think you can just buy these attachments, but yeah, I'm pretty excited. I got this again for $10. The seal seems to work great. Seems to light every time. The only downside about this is the little hole, the pinhole that the butane comes out of. I don't know if you can see that. Well, there's a pinhole and it likes to turn. It's like turning inside. And so I noticed every couple of lights, I have to grab my pliers and ever so gently turn it so that the hole is facing straight out again. I don't know why it does that, but it just does. So it's kind of a pain in the butt. But I figure for a vintage lighter that works and I didn't have to do any maintenance on it, I think it's a pretty killer deal. Very, very cool looking. I'll show you guys a close up here. Pretty much brand spanking new. So yeah, if you have a vintage Colibri lighter, check out Monogas. Check out Newport for the blue tip for Colibri Monogas. Yeah, that's my review here of the Colibri dual flame tool here. Seems to work great. Anyways, you guys have a wonderful day. If you want to see more vintage lighters and stuff like that, let me know. I'll definitely post some stuff up. And yeah, thanks again.